I swear I've got some Caribbean blood in me. There's no doubt about that, because that speaks to me in a way that it doesn't to other men.
That was Handyman. Fantastic. By Lord Kitchener.
Lord Kitchener, the great Lord Kitchener. We have been joined by Mr. Gary Wilmot. Gary, how are you?
I'm all right, thank you.
It's so nice to see you. Thank you for coming in.
That's nice to be here as well. I mean, I'm pleased to see you got over your cold from last week as well, because you sounded pretty duff on
I was yeah. awful last week. Have you had the flu thing yet?
No, I think I'm on the verge of getting it now, actually.
Oh, that's bad news.
Yeah,
then.
I know.
Especially with you performing, it must be a real worry.
Yeah, it is. I mean, when people come along to see somebody in the show, they want to see that somebody they paid for.
So, yeah, of course.
And that's the car, of course.
So why, then, have you been so remiss in not getting a flu jab?
I know, I should, though. I'm at that age now. I'm starting to feel the cold.
You've been of age for a while,
yeah.
As have I.
I've started tucking my vest in my underpants now. That's how cold it's getting.
And we've seen Henry Coop on the TV warning us. And if it's good enough for our Henry, then we should be doing it.
Absolutely. Well, yeah.
But I can tell you have absolutely no intention of getting one.
Well, I should do, really.
But you're not going to, are you?
No, by contract, I had to get one a couple of years ago.
And you didn't.
And they dashed me into this place in Knightsbridge somewhere. It's a doctor. And they said, don't worry, they'll all be waiting for you. You'll be rushed through. And I go in there, and they take me to this little room, and this woman kind of got the needle going. She says, all right, drop your trousers. And I start to undo my trousers. She said, no, just roll your sleeve up. It's all right. So I've been frightened to get one ever since.
She can see you an obliging soul. Gary Wilmot is currently in the London Palladium, appearing as Caractacus Potts.
Caractacus Potts.
Caractacus Potts.
Yeah, sorry, yeah.
Is he Caractacus Teapots or something, isn't he?
I don't know, is he?
Teapots.
It's not mentioned in the show.
It's not on the show.
But it was very remiss of you, actually, because a flying car was mentioned earlier on in the show today.
Phineas,
with the sledge, and you didn't think of the car.
We didn't think of tying it in. And apparently the car in the Chitty Chitty Bang Bang live stage extravaganza at the London Palladium is exceptional.
It is amazing.
Does it really fly?
It's magic. Absolutely. It really flies.
It really
People
flies.
Think there are wires or things underneath it.
It's, but actually
it's not.
Flying.
It actually flies.
It's powered by love.
Yeah, that's it.
And goodwill of children. I helped some people out last week.
Oh, yeah.
Saturday, after my radio show, not feeling very well, went and parked my car in London. A few people looked a bit lost in the big smoke. Mm-hmm. Said to me, excuse me, do you know the way to London Palladium? I directed them.
Fantastic. Well, I, on behalf of the whole company...
I'm waiting for some sort of official thanks.
I'd like to thank you.
I did well, shout I after them. Michael Ball's not in it anymore, by the way. Don't get your hopes up. it must be tough, though, following someone like Michael, who's obviously made a part of that his own for a while, and then you have to step in and basically do your thing with it.
Is it's not tough to actually do it, because when I step into the rehearsal room on the first day, I'm only looking at it from my perspective, so it's not really tough for me.
Did you see him in it?
I did, yeah, about a week into rehearsal.
Any good, was he?
Yeah, he was good,
overrated?
Michael, yes.
You were saying overrated, you thought? Overrated? Not as good as he should have been? Not committed,
I wasn't saying that at all. I mean, we all bring talent to whatever we're doing.
Not as much talent, you didn't think? Not as convincing.
You're not drawing me into this one, mate. I thought
no,
it was
Dick
fantastic.
Van Dyke, that's what you said, I believe.
I said, well, yes, I mean, any show would be better of having Dick Van Dyke in
a way, that must be a tough act to follow. I know you're not literally following him, but the idea that we go along and we've seen the movie.
Yeah. Well, it's true. I think a lot of children are surprised because of, because I don't really look that much like...
Being a gentleman of colour.
Absolutely. Which is quite odd because I've got Russ Abbott as my father and I've got two children with blonde hair and blue eyes.
So, not literally as your father. I mean, yeah, he isn't your father, is he?
I don't know.
What a family tree that would be.
But such is musical theatre. You can do what you like.
No,
I love that bit in West Side Story where the guy, this can only ever happen in musicals, where the guy looks up, Tony, I think it is, looks up at all those windows and shouts at the top of his voice, Maria! And only one woman.
Only one woman comes out in an Hispanic part of town, yeah.
That's it, you got it.
Oh, now that's a musical. Never mind Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, West Side Story, that is a musical.
Oh, that's fantastic. Always when I'm struggling.
Are you doing
that? Yeah, that was fantastic. You don't need piano lessons, mate. You could make your living as a whistler.
When you're a jet, you're a jet. All the way from your first cigarette to your last dying day. When you're a jet, you're a jet. Anyway, it's the beginning. It's great. And then he lost it, didn't he? It's not as good as it should be. It must be great being in a musical. I bet it's fun if you're in the right mood.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I mean, I've got a lovely dressing room, to all intents and purposes, at a flat in the middle of town that's paid for.
Wonderful.
So that's fantastic.
Well, they've smartened all up. I once was backstage at the Palladium years ago for a Royal Variety Show, and I shared a very small backstage area with, sounds like I'm making up, what a great lineup this was. There was Carol Deckard from T'Pau, Debbie Gibson, the American singer-songwriter, Terence Stamp, and Sean Connery.
Well, that's a bunch there, mate.
All look at me saying, who the hell let the bloke with no talent in? But what a lineup. But the reason I raise this is back then, and this was about 88, something like that, the dressing rooms backstage, and it was awful. It was really run down. I was amazed at how sort of shabby it was.
Well, there are two dressing rooms that are absolutely fine. That's the number one and the A dressing room.
And you have the number one?
Yeah. Yes, yeah, I do.
And who is the A? Russell, Russ Abbott.
Russ is that, yeah.
But they're equally... kids are kept in boxes outside.
Well, as you further up the building you go. But it's a very industrial area to be in, you know. Mm. In fact, if it wasn't for the fact there were people watching, being on stage, you'd need to have a hard hat on because there's things going on above you, bits of scenery and all the rest of it.
Because
you
know, of the dynamics of the show itself.
But it can be a very dangerous place to be on stage in a theatre. You know, there's pieces of scenery flying in and flying out. And, you've just got to have your wits about you.
Also, I suppose it's a kind of an energy-draining thing to be in a show which is as energetic as that and as kind of demanding as that is. I mean, it's kind of almost non-stop singing and dancing, not all the way through. I mean,
yeah,
little bits
is.
Of exposition, but really it's the songs that we go for and the routines.
Well, that's true, but I mean, I think, yeah, they're the things that drawing. I mean, when musicals first start, of course, there were no videos around, so really they were a way of people like Howard Keel getting their new song out there.
And the grass is as high as an elephant's eye.
That's fantastic.
Bit of Coward Keel there for you. How about that?
Who?
People are looking
Coward Keel.
Noel Coward Keel, the famous singer, songwriter,
playwright,
jive artist.
Well, that was just you nearly got a film. Have you ever thought of doing musical theatre?
I was offered Caracatus Potts, but I turned it down because the range wasn't there for me.
Gary, don't encourage him.
I wanted to make him cry as well as laugh, Gary.
No, when I do Mary Poppins, so I think you make a lovely Mary Poppins.
I would be lovely, wouldn't
you? You would be beautiful,
and because I'm practically perfect in every way.
Of course you are, and your feet are at that angle. Well, I'm demonstrating
are,
now, aren't I?
Slightly splayed, actually.
You're there already.
I've got a ballerina's gait.
Yeah.
So anyone keep the dogs out.
Hey, there
I apologise for the quality of the material this morning, ladies and gentlemen. Sister Sledge just kind of knocked the wind out of me. Old Bamboo.
What about it?
Me Old Bamboo. That's the big showstopping number that you have, I guess, in it, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a few. It's Hushabye Mountain.
Oh, I love Hushabye Mountain.
Yeah, give us a few.
No, you do it. Come on, let's have a bit.
No, I've got to work
Come
in
on,
a few
never
hours.
Never mind working a few hours. Let's have a bit. Entice
them
in.
A gentle breeze from Hushabye Mountain.
That's nice.
Softly blows, oh, lullaby bell.
Hello. We're doing the... What was that hole for?
That was a low. Somebody on top of the mountain calling down.
The mountain. No one's trapped on
calling
that.
Hello.
Up there. You do Billy Goats and Alton Horns next.
Oh, yeah, that'll get the kids off to sleep. But listen, I have to hijack your children and bring them along. You can't take them. You're too busy. But all your children, I'd love to bring them to the theatre to see it. Because I heard you talking a few weeks ago to Michael.
You're making me feel like
you are a terrible father. I don't know how the back injury came about.
It's not just I don't have the time. It's just I don't want to spend it with them.
Well, there you are, you see.
Fair enough. At least I'm an honest father.
You appease them with just playing a silly song on the radio for them. And you think that's being a father. Well, it's
I would like to come and see you.
Oh, you would?
Well, now ball's out of it, I'll come. I would love to come and see it. And I do fully intend to, because, you know, it's the sort of thing as well, when you go and see a show with your family like that, it is a great night out. I mean, you have a lot of fun when you go. We've seen a few things like that together. I went to see Joseph with him a while ago.
Yeah.
And it was, you know, it's no Chitty Chitty Bang Bang.
No, well, I don't know, it's a good show.
Although they had inflatable sheep and a camel in it. Either that or the cold medicine had kicked in, I'm not sure, but I remember seeing something out the corner of my eye that alarmed me. What's that?
Well, I tell you, Russ has only just joined the show about a month ago, I suppose, Russ Abbott, yeah. And we're sitting in the back of the car at the end when it's flying off, and the noise from the crowd is just astonishing.
I bet it's incredible.
And I turned to him, I said, you don't get this in Shakespeare, do you? He said, no, you don't. I've done all sorts of theatre, but your audience reaction like this, you never get.
Shakespeare overrated.
Is that what you really think, so?
You just said so.
No, I didn't say that. I'm just saying you don't get
Wilmot
that kind of reaction
in Shakespeare,
it.
Not as good as Chitty Chitty Bang Bang Storm. That's the headline in the Stage and Television Today next week.
Yeah.
Wilmot spits on Macbeth, wants only to do Dr. Doolittle.
Wilmot not invited to Stratford ever again.
Judy Dench calls Wilmot a fool. Newspapers, if this was the movie of your life, newspapers would be spinning together. Vorderman agrees with Wilmot. Shakespeare lousy. Riddled with plot faults.
No songs, yeah.
Anyway, Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, though, must be, yeah. I would have thought, just a great part to have. If you're in the West End, if you're in the theatre, to be in a show like that with all that stuff going on around you, I can imagine for you it must be just a real kind of buzz.
It's a great feeling. I mean, the show itself is 2.5 hours long, and I'm on stage for maybe an hour and a hour and a half, maybe, of that.
Who plays the toy maker in it?
Freddie Lees. Freddie was...
That was Benny Hill in the movie, of course.
It was Benny Hill, yeah. Yeah, and we got Wayne Sleep, of course, as the child catcher.
Yeah, let's not depress ourselves. Life art imitating yourself again.
Wayne scares me without the gear on.
Yeah,
and when he puts that stuff on,
we saw him in the jungle. He's a terrifying little fella.
Terrifying.
He can still do a pirouette with the best of them, can't he?
He certainly can. I mean, that's the amazing thing. I mean, this man is a man who's danced with some of the best ballet dancers in the world. And
name three of them.
Dame Marmaine. Dame Fonzie.
Gowie once had a proper job.
Yeah.
Okay. Unlike us. Because we've never really had proper jobs. No. I mean, you worked in a job centre once, but that's like someone desperately avoiding actually having worked, just holding it on. You were a scaffolder, weren't you?
I was a scaffolder, yeah.
How long were you a scaffolder for?
About 18 months.
I have great admiration for scaffolders.
Do you really, yeah.
Especially in the cold.
That's the thing that put me off. Ooh. After the second winter, I didn't want to do that
Can
anymore.
You imagine those poles in the cold weather? I worked in a fruit shop once. I didn't like getting the beetroots out when it was cold. Seriously.
I know. You got
beets have a higher water content. They get freezing. You put it in the beets. I don't want to serve them.
Yeah,
beets.
Absolutely right.
But the cold pipes and the when you're putting the scaffold in them.
Yeah, tubes. Yeah, really. It was cold. And we did a lot of work in the West End as well, around the city and stuff like that. And it was freezing cold. But when work was a bit scarce, either it was too cold or there wasn't too much work out there scaffolding, we'd be in the yard there loading and unloading lorries that were going out, and to scrape 4 or 5 inches of snow off of those poles in the morning. And I just said, right, I've had enough. There's got to be more to life than this.
That's not great. So, but now it must be weird, because you're presumably walking past scaffolders in the West End on the way to Chitty Chitty Bang Bang.
And I do, and I'm going,
yeah, but for the grace.
Look at the way they've done that.
Yeah, are you critical of their work?
Oh, am I critical?
What do you call those things that you join the two scaffolding poles at a right angle together in?
Well, there are several different kinds.
You've forgotten, haven't you?
I have, yeah. But there are several different kinds, yeah.
I like the look of those tools.
Do you want some?
Part of me feels like I should be doing that, and I'm sure there's many listeners out there who would agree with that estimation. But whenever I see actual labour being done, I get quite, oh, that'd be good to actually have a skill like that, to know the name of parts. It's a manly thing, isn't it?
Clips and spigots and
You're
stuff
making
like that.
This up, Wilmore. No, I'm beginning to doubt when you ever went up a scaffold.
I'll tell you what, it stood me in good stead when I had to go up Nelson's Column, because that was a real...
Oh,
in fact, I was working with your brother,
now. When did you go up Nelson's Column? What are you
I can't remember the year now, but it was to celebrate a programme called the Saturday 6 o'clock show.
I don't think this ever happened.
Your brother was up a scaffold.
No, he wasn't. He wasn't. No,
if you'd gone up Nelson's Column, you'd remember the bloody year, wouldn't you?
Yeah, and you remember if it was a skivet or
a cup. You don't have to impress us, OK? We're impressed enough already.
No, I'm not. No, I'm impressed with you about the beetroot, the cold beetroots. I mean, anyone who knows that must have done the job.
I had a fruit job. I was a Saturday boy.
How many different kinds of beetroot are there, then?
I don't know, but they're all cold in the weather.
There are clipped beetroots.
And there used to be one woman who came to the shop. I was about 15, 16. There was one, I like to think she was a single mother, used to come by, and I used to pick out the bigger potatoes for her. And I used to hope that she would notice that and maybe be my friend. Never noticed. Because everyone wanted the bigger spuds because there's less peeling.
Is that...
Well, don't act like you don't know. That's common knowledge.
There's a tip for you, folks.
Everyone wants a bigger spud. They should give us some big ones.
Bigger chips are less fat.
She looks a bit like Sally Thompson. Let's have a bit more music, and we're going to enjoy Gary's company some more after this. What are we going to play?
I've got time for a bit of old rock and roll, 2 minutes worth of it.
Bug it in. It was Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll. Gary Wilmot is with us, ladies and gentlemen. He's in Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. I'm dismayed to find out, not for that much longer.
Well, actually, only for another 3 weeks. I'm basically out of it for December and January, because I came into Chitty at quite short notice, and I'd already got a commitment for Panto, and I'm in Panto down in Plymouth.
And then you're coming back to Chitty Chitty Bang Bang after that?
Coming back. I'm basically out of the show for December and January.
Right.
And then I'm back in from February and March.
Who's going to be taking over the role?
We don't know yet. They're keeping it all under
hat.
Me old bamboo.
I'll put a word in for you if you
want. Put a word in?
Absolutely.
When are these calls coming in for me? They're never coming in. I've got to get myself an agent. The Panto you're doing in Plymouth, what's it going to be?
It's Dick Whittington. Dick Whittington.
Turn Again, Gary Wilmot.
Yeah, and it's with John Challis, you know, well, Del Boy.
Never heard of
Marlene,
him.
Marlene.
Boise, he was.
Boise,
never heard of him.
You know him.
And what show was he on?
Only Fools and Horses.
Never heard of him.
Didn't do very well.
No, he's a lovely fellow. I've met him. Yeah. He's a really nice guy.
And Jeffrey Holland, Spike from Heidi High.
Yeah, don't know that one. who else did it?
Gary Wilmot's in it.
Gary Wilmot, we've heard of.
You've heard of him, yeah.
What ladies are in there? They normally have a young lady from a soap or a pop band or something.
Well, it's Casey
thing.
Lee Jollis, who's no stranger to pantomime. And if you've ever watched a programme, you probably wouldn't, because you need to watch it with your kids. It's called Beachcomber Bay.
I've seen Beachcomber Bay.
Oh, well, there you
Not
are.
With my children.
Yeah.
Well, that sounds like fun, though. I mean, it must be fun doing pantomime.
Oh, it's really hard work, but it's great fun. Yeah.
And you're playing Dick, presumably.
I'm playing...
I'd love to be in a panto.
You'd be very good in a panto.
I'd love to be in a panto.
Do you need a cat?
I could see you two as ugly sisters.
With
the greatest respect. I think
don't you have to do a northern accent to be an ugly sister? Because my accents are a little bit variable. Don't you? Normally they are. You think of like Les Dawson doing it, don't you? You think of, you like that. Ooh, cinders, where's me faggots? You know, like northern voices.
No, you don't. That's the bottom line. No.
Well, that's settled that then. Gary Wilmot can be seen in pantomime in Plymouth quite soon. In the meantime, if you get the chance to be in London, I'm imagining the tickets are fairly scarce, but I think they still have some available.
That's absolutely right.
Yeah. Get yourself down to see Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. I'm gonna try and see it while you're in it before you go off to panto, I think.
Thank you, the time
is now. And then back after Christmas.
That's right, until March.
Gary, thanks so much for coming. It's really nice to spend some time with you.
And nice to see you too.
Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed the show. Join us again next week. I think Peter Gay's gonna be one of our
Peter
shows.
Kay, yeah.
Peter Kay's going to be on the show next week, which will be good fun.
Oh, he's good.
Join us then. ADH 91 FM. This is Radio 2 from the BBC.